To thanks to the, to any person for the first Maghrebian Congress of Clinical Anatomy. In the first Congress, I want to present the development of the three-dimensional finite element model of the knee. In about this title, I want to why we did this project. We did this project because there is some physical activities like compression force in the knee joint. This force can reach seven times in the body weight. This load can lead. Can lead the knee joint of the some disease like the traumatism and dislocation and sprain and degenerative process and the other disease like the tears. I propose the understand of the biomechanics of the knee joint to improve the prevention of the treatment procedure of these injuries. In this context, we develop the three-dimensional solid of the solid finite model of the knee joint to predict the stress in each individual component of the knee joint, like the femur, tibia, and cartilages and meniscus. The aim objectives of this work: the first aim to discover the component of the knee joint, and the second aim is to review the literature on the subject of the state of the art. In this title, we present the X studies for the created model of the knee joint. And the third aim is to use the finite element model of for modeling of the knee joint and how created the 3D model. After, we present how we use the 3D model of the knee joint for explain some disease like tears of ligament and meniscus and degeneration of cartilages. Now the introduction. The knee is the most complex of the knee joints, contains the femur and the patella and the fibula and the tendon connect between bones and the muscle, and the ligaments links between two bones, and the TC shaped is called meniscus. The main objectives of this research is develop the element of the knee joint to predict the stress in each individual of the components, and after the reconstruction of the tibia and meniscus and ligament and cartilage, the model were generated from software. It's called Mimics and Rapid Form. When we obtain the model 3D of the knee joint, we can apply it in this model the some disease like the tears, like the tears, and the other disease in our models we use for put the simulation or for the present how effect the tears for disease of the knee joint and the healthy knee joint. We use the software. Software is called Abaqis. This is the knee joint, the component of the knee joint. These are the same pictures, present the bones of the knee joint. And the two pictures are presented presented meniscus and the cartilages of the knee joint. And these pictures present the muscles in the upper leg, posterior and the posterior. This picture present the posterior of the knee of the upper leg. This picture presents the tendon of the ligaments and command the knee injuries and disease of the knee joint, like this picture presents the meniscal tears in the knee joint. And this picture presents the degenerative cartilages in this knee joint. Now for the talk about the modeling of the knee joint in the X studies is divided this the fine element modeling of the knee joint into two parts. The first part is called is called the physical part. Like this pictures present the X model created. This is a huge model for the studies, the angle and this link in the knee joint. And the second types of the models is the called the mathematicals or computer models. And this picture present the X studies about the knee joint. Now we talk about the design of the geometric model of the knee joint. How created our model of the knee joint? The first step is MRI images or magnetic resonance images. This is a real model of a volunteer female age 45 years. This slide's thickness 1.5 millimeters and total scanning was approximately 18 minutes and 1.00 Tesla. And this now we take this model of the MRI. We imported in the other, import this images of the MRI into the software. It's called Mimix Density Segmentation 3D Reconstruction for the created 3D model of the knee joint. After that, we use the other software. It's called RapidForm for the created the smooth surface of our model of the knee joint. Finally, we exported this model to the software. It's called Mimi. Is called Abacus for the complete our studies in our studies, like the simulation. This is how the generation of STL of file STL. This is our MRI, the files imported in this software is called Mimix. We use the sum function like the segmentation and the properties for the created the Boolean properties for the created 3D model of the knee joint. This picture present the Mimix imported duty slacks. When we imported the images of MRI or CT tomography or X-ray images, the software Mimix is converted automatically these stacks of images to DCOM. The DCOM is the format enter. Is the inner in the Mimix. When we imported the file, we can work now for the segmentation and the Boolean equation and the Boolean properties for the created 3D model. The Mimix, we can present this is the model of the knee joint after segmentation and the Boolean equation. This picture present the farmer in the software is called Remesh. Why we imported the model 3D in this? Because the Mimix can obtain the former STL, have the sum debris and the sum the whole in our models. By the Remesh Mimix, we can obtain maybe smooth surface in our model. After After this slide, this presents the 3D reconstruction of the knee joint using a rapid form software. This rapid form software, when we imported the model from Mimics, when you obtained the model contained the debris and the hole in the our models. When you use it in the rapid form, the rapid form give us the model of the knee joint don't have the debris and have the smooth surface. This model, when obtained from Mimics from STL, after that use this imported the model from Mimics to rapid form, we can see the hole in our surface. By rapid form, we gain the smooth surface and we can create the some surfaces in our model of the knee joint. This the finally of our model of the knee joint. This picture is containing the bone of the knee joint. This is the whole model of the knee joint. This is the femoral cartilage and meniscus and the cartilages of the tibia. And like the same studies we use in the other volunteers, is male, aged 45, but in these models we have the ligaments and the cartilage of the patella and the patella. This is whole model of the knee joint after Mimics a rapid form finally we obtained the model of the knee joint like this. Now we have the other software, it's called Abaqis. Why we use the Abaqis software for studying the some disease or present or explain the some disease of the knee joint in the 3D model. When you exported the models of the knee joint, we can obtain the model like this. And at this picture, finally we can take the model of the knee joint. We can apply the force of the knee joint in the caprice at this direction. This is the cartilages and the cartilage of femoral and meniscus and the cartilages of the tibia. At this, we use the simulation or we studying or use the studying of the disease of the knee joint in this software. This picture presents the force is applied at this point of the knee joint. Now present the partial longitudinal meniscectomy of the knee joint. This is a healthy meniscus, and this part is meniscectomy or the sum partial from this party. Finally, we can use two studies. The first studies is contain the model of the healthy meniscus, and the second studies contain the meniscectomies, and we can do the comparison between two models. And this picture present the degeneration of cartilages at this surface and this healthy of the cartilages. We can use always the same model. We can use always to study between healthy and the disease of degeneration of cartilages. The conclusion in our project, we present the detailed 3D dimension of finite element of the knee joint, of the knee joint, the three models contain the ligament and the cartilages and the cartilages and the femur and the tibia, and the tibia. Finally, the finite element simulation helped to understand the stress distribution in the human knee and to prevention joint injuries and pathological degeneration of articular joint. Three-dimensional finite element model can also be used to estimate and consequences of the surgical treatments such as the total or partial meniscectomies.